The Sierra picking up more snow today. Here's a look at some of the snowfall this afternoon around Truckee. Measuring the snowfall in the Sierra has become more important than ever. It impacts the amount of water that is available throughout the state.
And scientists are constantly checking the numbers and analyzing the data. KCRA3's Jason Marks shows us where it all happens.
Near the Sierra summit.
I just love it up here.
Surrounded by the tallest of trees.
Honestly, I kind of see paradise.
And just past the place where two roads diverge.
This place really is just a little cabin in a big forest.
Andrew Schwartz found his dream house.
It is very isolated.
So isolated that in the winter, it takes drastic measures just to reach his front door.
In some regards, it's nice to not have to worry about the hustle and bustle of the city, but not quite as easy to have, Uber bring up food when you want a cheeseburger.
Hey.
Oh, hey, welcome up to the cabin.
So this is where you work.
It's not easy.
Schwartz is 37.
This is it. This is where the magic happens.
And has a Ph.D. in atmospheric science. That's a fancy way for saying he's a scientist who studies the weather and climate.
And what are you looking for?
In the forecast?
Yeah, in general.
Sustained precipitation.
And he's just the latest.
Oh, these are cool. There's actually a long history of different people living here.
And a long line of very smart people.
It's a fascinating history, to say the least.
Who have all waited for the sky to fall.
This is the snow lab. It's in its humble glory, which doesn't make sense.
In the mid 40s.
Here's an entry from March 30th, 1946. 14 inches of snow from 6 p.m. last night to 12 noon today.
The Army Corps of Engineers and the National Weather Service.
Some of the researchers definitely have better handwriting than others.
Opened the Central Sierra Snow Lab.
These are, they're all writings from ghosts of the past.
It's a place to measure how much snow was on the ground.
There's been snow measurements occurring up here since 1879.
Railroad workers would keep track of the yearly accumulation.
The fact that these records go back so far really is mind-boggling.
Giving today's scientists
1881, we only had a maximum snow depth of 3 feet and had a total snowfall of 13 feet. So having years with little snowfall isn't a new thing by any means.
A stockpile of records.
It is really one of the longest snowpack records in the entire world.
In the 90s, UC Berkeley took control of the lab. And today, Schwartz goes through the same process as so many did before him.
Issue with us getting it in and out. And then we'll go ahead and weigh it.
It helps to determine how much the climate is changing. And over the last couple years, how much water Northern California will have in reserve.
In drought years, it's really important because it can tell us whether or not we're going to be able to pull out of that drought, or whether we can start working on, even pulling down the severity of the drought a little bit. And it'll tell us how much water we can use going into the future. Will we need to keep our water restrictions in place, or can we kind of start easing things up a little bit?
So when Schwartz does leave, the warmth of the lab.
You get your hands dirty from time to time, but what's better than playing in the dirt?
The importance gives even him chills.
I'd love to stay here as long as I can. It's paradise up here, and I'm very fortunate to be able to do this, and I'm excited to keep this lab going and bring it into the 21st century.
Except, of course, when you realize you have errands that need to be run.
Have to head into the post office.
All of it in the name of science. For photojournalist Drew Falk,
it's incredibly peaceful.
Jason Marks, KCRA 3 News.
And Schwartz says after having the most snowfall in December, Mother Nature followed it up with the least snowfall since 1970 in the month of January.
And in the past 24 hours, scientists at the lab report more than 11 inches of snow.